Hi, welcome to QlikFix. This video will show an example of how analytic connections can be used to enable external calculation engines that act as service-side extensions. In this example, QlikSense connects to an R server for extending expression capabilities in QlikSense apps while offloading the calculations to an R server engine. Analytics connection uses gRPC protocol to communicate with the server-side extension. gRPC does not support R script language, so we need to use the open source QlikSense R plugin as a connector to the R server. The plugin can be downloaded on the web in this location. Make sure to review the contents of the README file, including the license information. Qlik support does not support this R plugin software directly, which is provided as is. Inquiries should be submitted via GitHub under this location. In this example, we will download, build, and run the plugin on the R server. First, download and unzip the contents where the plugin will live moving forwards. Then we need to build the project using Microsoft Visual Studios. A prerequisite for the R plugin is Visual Studios 2015 or later. Open the solution file server-side-extension.sln and run the build twice. This should create the plugin executable under this location. Next, since the plugin default setting is to accept only local requests via the loopback interface, we will configure it to listen for connections requests on all network interfaces of the R server. Open the config file shown here and under gRPC host, set the value to 0.0.0.0. Also note that in this scenario, the default setting of the R server host value as the loopback IP will work since the plugin is being installed on the R server. The R plugin connection to R is made to a service called RServe, which may not have been installed yet. RServe can be installed via the R console in either RGUI or RStudios with the following commands. To install the RServe package, we'll need to pick a mirror, then invoke the needed library, and start the RServe server. Note that additional dependent libraries may need to be installed depending on the desired functionality. See information on this under the Get Started file in GitHub. Next, we can run the R plugin executable SSE to rserve.exe, which will start listening on port 50051 by default. Now we can finally configure the analytic connection via QMC. The name of the connection is actually used within the QlikSense app when invoking the server-side extension. We will name it R as it is referenced this way in example QlikSense apps available. The host field should be set to the host name of the server running the R plugin. Keep in mind that even if the plugin is installed on the QlikSense central node, if there are other RIM nodes in the environment with the engine service enabled, the host name should be set to the actual server name, not as localhost. Next, set the default TCP port for the plugin and click Apply. The R plugin includes sample QlikSense apps which can be imported. With this particular sample app, we can look at basic load script statements and expressions that do not require any additional library packages. Note in the load script editor how the extension clause needs to precede in the name given to the plugin in the configure analytic connection, which in this case is named R. See more information on load script syntax on Qlik's help site under the following location. In app objects, the expression syntax is similar and starts with the plugin name configured in the analytics connection, followed by the available function retrieved from the plugin. When using the default functions included with the R plugin, an R script string needs to be included as a parameter, along with the references to the data to be submitted with the request. In this example, we use the rscript function paste to concatenate the first and second word submitted as data. In this other KPI object, we use a define function to only submit the data and obtain the result. Define functions can be added on the fly to the functions definitions JSON file shown here. In order to enable this functionality, add the JSON file path string as a value for the parameter shown here in the plugin configuration file mentioned earlier in the video. The server-side extension plugin activity can be observed when running the process interactively. The activity also gets registered in the log files under this location. Reviewing this sample app, we can see more examples of other custom expressions that use the server-side extension and have the calculation offloaded to the R server. If you would like more information, take advantage of the expertise of peers, product experts, and technical support engineers by asking a question in a Qlik product forum on Qlik Community, or search for answers using the new Search Unify tool. It searches across our knowledge base, Qlik Help, Qlik Community, Qlik YouTube channels, and more, all from one place. Also check out the support program space. Here, you learn directly from Qlik experts via support webinar like Techsperts Thursdays. And don't forget to subscribe to the support update blog. Thanks for watching. Nailed it.